Good morning, students. Welcome to a new class of Oracle, that is class 5. Previously, we have discussed about what is Oracle, its features, benefits, everything. And today in this class, we will discuss about the tools. Those are used for Oracle in order to support its operations. There are certain tools available. Out of that, Oracle database is one. Oracle database that is created in order to store the real world data. Whichever data the user want to execute or process, those information will be stored there, and the required informations can be retrieved at the respective time period. Okay, only required data is retrieved and unnecessary data will not be retrieved. That is maintained by the Oracle database. Got it? And SQL. SQL means the structured query language. It is one of the major tools of Oracle, using which you can write query lines or provide the commands to the users in order to execute their actions. Whatever requirements, queries, operations are needed by the user are there, those can be written using the SQL, structured query language, and the system will process it and the user will get the result out of it. Got it? SQL is a command-based query language. Here we will write the query lines using certain commands, and one line after, when one line is finished, it is being executed and the result is provided. So you can say it is an interactive query language. Got it? And the more benefited feature or tool, benefited tool of Oracle is the PLSQL. That is programming language, structured query language, in which we will write programs, and the programs will be written in order to execute the actions. As a set of commands, all at once will be provided and the result will be come out after that. Here you are writing all the commands in a single program, and when the program is executed, the output will be gained by the user. Got it? Database will be created, database operations will be operated, data manipulations can be executed, and where the database will be used, that can be also written using the PLSQL programs. Got it? Programs, you already know, it is a set of commands, set of query lines. In PLSQL you can write, and all the query lines all at once will be executed in order to solve a particular task. Got it? Then next is the forms. Forms, it is the front end tool, and the forms we are creating in order to create a user interface for the user. When the user have some queries to provide through forms, it can write its actions. It can provide its queries. You can say form are the format in which your required queries you can input, and it will help the database to collect the data from the user at the time of database creation and database executions. You can input your information through the forms. You can watch the executions throughout the forms. You can watch the updations performed in the databases through the forms. You can see your inputs are provided in a right way and being executed in a perfect manner can be watched through the forms. Okay? Forms is the medium through which you can provide your queries, provide your inputs to the database for execution. Got it? when the data is being executed, another tool available to provide the output to the user in their respective formats, that is the report. The report contains the user output in which the user's requisite results will be shown in a perfect format so that he can use it for its requirements. Got it? The reports are necessary for the database to provide so that the user will be satisfied by using it. Then another tool is your graphics, the GUI format, graphical user interface format, in which format your inputs can be provided in a proper manner, can be guided through the graphics actions. It can be used to implement the graphical user interface to create so that we can provide our queries in a proper manner. The graphics supports the user-friendly attractiveness to be created by the databases. It can be written using the high-level languages. Using the GUI format, the user's information can be perfectly represented in the forms. Got it? You have already discussed about the forms of the measure tools. Another measure tool is supporting the forms to be created in a perfect manner, that is graphics. Got it? Then is the SGA. SGA is the stored global area. This tool is very useful for executing the user sections. Whatever SQL queries you have written, whichever PLSQL programs you have written, those can be stored in the shared memory and it can execute the actions and help the user to receive the result out of it. Whichever inputs you are providing to the database are being stored at a location, then it is executed by the system, then output is provided and stored there. After that, the result will be shown to the user. So in order to execute the informations provided by the user, there is a space available, storage space available, that is called as your stored global area. The input informations will be stored, the results will be calculated, the results will be stored, then the results will be displayed through the outer interface. Let's watch how all these forms, how all these tools you can use, and all these the operations of all these tools you can watch in the three-tier architecture of the database. Got it? It is the internal architecture of the database. How the database look like, how the database performs its executions internally, how it takes the data from the user, how it processes it, where it executes the SQL, PLSQL programs, and in which place the data will be permanently stored, and in which place the user's output will be received. The three-tier architecture contains a clear picture of it. Let's watch how the three-tier architecture looks like. This is the figure of three-tier architecture. The three-tier architecture contains three tiers. One is the user tier or the view tier. Second is the logical tier. And third is the physical tier. Got it? In the view tier, it is called as user's view. The user can write its queries. The user can provide its inputs. The user can watch its reports in the view tier. The view tier also can be of many numbers when it is available in a distributed database system. Number of viewers can be also present. Number of users also can be present in this tier. Got it? And where your data is being executed, that is provided by the user at the view tier, that is the logical tier place. In the logical tier, all the executions on the data can be operated. And for this, there are SQL and PLSQL formats. In SQL, you can write query lines, interactive query lines. In PLSQL, you can write programs. A set of procedure that is combinedly executing many number of query lines at a time. Got it? The physical tier where the real data exists, the databases where the data is being stored. The databases stores the data whenever the user creates a database. Whenever the user want to modulate the database, update the database, change its data, existing data, or want to add some more data, the physical tier will update these actions. All the required actions by the users can be supported by the physical tier. And to perform the executions of the physical tier, the databases are exist where the real internal databases exist to store the data. And updations will be also made on that. Got it? When your user is providing certain information to execute, that is provided through the view tier, being executed by the logical tier and stored in the physical tier. When the data is executed, then it will be again sent to the logical tier. Then from the logical tier, it will move to the view tier and the output can be received by the users. Got it? When the executions on SQL and PLSQL are operated, then the SGA is being used. Stored global area is being used. The SGA, stored global area, receives the logical tiers informations written in SQL and PLSQL, execute those. As in the database systems, you have learned about conceptual level. In conceptual level, all the logical actions are carried out. The conceptual level operates the data. And the conceptual level receives the data in the query format. Whichever respective query lines are available, command lines are available, in that only the user have to write their query lines and those will be executed at a storage location. That is the stored global area. It is also called as the executable area in which your data executions will be performed. And after the executions being executed, it will be sent through the logical tier to the view tier to be shown by the users. Got it? In the forms, the view tier will receive the inputs. In graphics, it will arrange them in a proper manner. Then the query lines will be written in SQL and PLSQL, and all those will be available in the logical tier. Then the executions on the operation PLSQL or SQL lines will be operated in the SGA. The data will be stored in the physical tier at the same moment. Whenever the data is being ready to be permanently stored, which is identified by SGA, will be updated in the internal databases in the physical tier. Got it? And whenever updations are to be made also, the SGA allows to verify the operations and update them inside the physical tiers, internal databases. Got it? When particular information is to be retrieved, those are already existing, then also we have to provide through certain SQL or PLSQL programs. That will be executed by the SGA and the information will be sent to the physical tier. Then the data will be retrieved from the internal databases, then being formulated by SGA. It will be sent through the logical tier and the data will be displayed in the form of reports to the user at the view tier. Got it? The view tier is the place where the user is being communicated with the database directly, providing its input through it and receiving its result through it. Understood? The picture already shows you the actions being operated in the internal level by the database systems. The three-tier architecture contains the whole executions on the databases. Got it? Next, we'll go for what is SQL. We have discussed about SQL, the SQL and PLSQL. It is one of the major tools of Oracle. So we should know about SQL more detail. SQL is being developed in the year 1970 by IBM. Okay. SQL is a query language that helps to interact with the database. The query language supports the query lines to be written, and those query lines will be executed by the database systems. And the user's inputs will be written in query languages, and that will be provided as the SQL query lines to the database so that it can be executed. So in order to communicate with the database, the user uses the SQL, structured query language. Got it? SQL is used to interact with the relational databases, you can say. Whatever relational actions we want to perform, those can be performed through SQL. We often refer relational databases as the SQL databases. Because of that, the relational databases are also defined as SQL databases. Because the relational database actions are being carried out by the database systems. And whenever the database operations are to be carried out, we can take help of the SQL. Some of the popular relational databases you can watch through examples like your MySQL, Oracle, PostgreSQL, MariaDB, like that. There are many relational database packages using which you can operate with the database systems. Create databases, define databases, manipulate the databases, update the data inside it, and perform respective actions of deletions, drop actions in the database systems. Got it? SQL is a simple and powerful language. Easily a user can write query lines using SQL. And it is also very powerful in order to operate the actions of the database requirements. Got it? And the being simple and powerful, it provides all type of actions in the databases to be supported. SQL is used to perform crude operations. Crude means create, delete, update, retrieve the required data from the databases. Got it? In the relational databases, frequently we need these actions to be carried out. That is creation of the database, retrieving the respective data from it, updating the changes inside the databases, delete the databases when it is no longer required. Got it? And to support all these crude actions, the relational databases takes help of the SQL, structured query language. Got it? SQL can also perform administrative tasks on databases, like your database security, backup of data, user management, maintaining protection measures, supporting sharing of information, like that. Administrative actions are very important to be supported by the databases so that the data can be secured and the data can be well managed. And the administrative actions are also being supported by SQL to carry out. Got it? we can create databases and tables inside the database using SQL. SQL is the structured query language. It is the interactive query language. Through the interactive command lines, you can create databases, you can create tables, and perform the executions required in the database. Got it? It consists of set of commands to access data. As it is a command-based system, query-based system, it has certain fixed set of commands, and using those commands only, you have to write your respective query lines. Got it? And SQL supports different application programs to be created. And application programs helps the users to access data. And the access of data can be supported through SQL also. Got it? SQL, PLSQL, PLSQL is there to write programs, procedures, collection of informations, and collection of certain PLSQL programs can be helpful for creating different application programs. And the application programs contain related programs to manage the databases, create databases, manage actions on the databases. For all sort of actions, you can create the application programs, and through the application programs, you can perform the executions on the database systems. And that is also supported by SQL. How SQL is important, you can mark here. The application programs are also dependent upon SQL to support the databases in performing their actions. Got it? It is a simple English-like language in which the queries are provided. Different query lines you can write using a simple English sentence. Simple English-like words are there so that the user or the programmer or the developer can easily remember and write the query lines. Got it? It also allows to add or remove users from the databases. Databases are there. The database is containing many number of database tables. The database have certain users also. Different users are performing their actions at different times. When there are number of users, to manage the number of users, you can also have SQL supporting query lines to do their actions. Got it? To perform the activities on the database, it can use the database languages like DDL, DML, DCL, TCL, etc. You can say these are the SQL query languages. Using these SQL query languages, you can write the query lines. You can use the commands existing in the SQL to manage the databases. Got it? SQL is originally based on relational algebra and tuple relational calculus to perform its operations. Got it? It is using the relational algebraic concepts and relational calculus actions on tuples so that the actions required to be made on the databases can be easily performed. Got it? The SQL supports the relational algebraic query lines to be written, relational calculus actions to be operated so that the relational actions on the databases can be well performed. Got it? SQL contains the commands also to provide security measures on the databases so that your database can be secure, protected. It will not be violating its originality. It will not violate the rules of database management. It will help to create a database in a perfect manner by supporting the consistency on the data, redundancy, maintenance on the data, data integrity can be available. Your data can be safe when it is being used in a shared construct. everything can be well managed through SQL. Got it? The security measures are too much important to be managed whenever the database concept is in hand. In order to manage that, the SQL is a very best tool. Got it? And Oracle provides an interface to execute the SQL queries. And that interface is called as the SQL Star Plus. Using an interface, the database can interact with the computer system. The query lines it can provide, the query lines will be executed and the results will be received. For that, there is an interface or communication medium required. And that interface is your SQL Star Plus. Okay? SQL, asterisk symbol, PLUS. Got it? This is the name of the interface that is used in the SQL for writing query lines and performing actions through SQL. Got it? And regarding this SQL Star Plus operation features, will go for another class. Okay? In the next class of us, we'll discuss about SQL Star Plus. Dear students, what you have learned in this class? In this class, we have discussed about the tools. Those are supported by Oracle. Okay? The PLSQL, SQL programs, Oracle databases to create, manage all the Oracle databases very well, create the forms, use the graphics, through the proper receiving of the reports, display the outputs to the user in a perfect manner, and when your data is being executed, how it will internally perfectly operated. That is the three-tier architecture. We have already learned about it. And whenever the informations to the system are provided and the actions are being executed, the SGA is being helpful for the execution. These all things we have learned. Okay, and one of the major tools of Oracle, that is SQL, that also we have discussed. The importance of SQL, the uses of SQL, how we are being benefited using SQL, we have discussed. Go through the video two or three times so that you can understand the things perfectly. Wait for the next class for the SQL interface, that is SQL Star Plus. Got it?